Hey y'all, Surfing Sapo here. Today is August 28th, 2014. We're going to cook some shrimps. And we're going to use the one, the only, Coakley's barbecue sauce. The one and only, folks. If you haven't tried it, you need to order some. I'll put a link in the description. Okay, let's get to the introduction, then we're going to get started. Our ingredients, folks. Got to have shrimp. Got a little tub here of shrimp, deveined, peeled. Got some one onion, one jalapeno, Surfing Sapo's special homemade Louisiana hot sauce, fresh black pepper, the one, the only, Coakley's barbecue sauce, original, barcode ingredients, all legit. Made in a laboratory, folks. The one, the only, Tango Spice Company, Cajun Rub. Same thing, barcode, ingredients, also made in a laboratory. These are the ingredients. We're going to melt down a stick of butter in a frying pan. While the butter's melting down, I'm going to add some Tango Spice Company Cajun Rub to the shrimp. Don't be shy, folks. Use a lot of it. It's good stuff. Get them nice and coated. See that? Get it all over. Let everybody get to know each other. You know the saying. There you go. We're waiting for the butter to melt down.
The onions are cooked down pretty good.
Now you turn the heat up. Yeah, it's pretty, ain't it? Now you turn the heat up to medium high. Put your shrimps in. Start stirring them around. Actually, give them some black pepper. That's enough. Now start stirring them immediately. They're going to cook fast. Get them all over the place. Stir fry. No. Kind of like stir fry, but it's cast iron fry. Remember, we're just cooking them until they turn pink. You do want to get them a nice kind of a crust on there. Not a crust, but cooked. You want that seasoning to burn a little bit. Not blacken, just kind of toast them. You'll see. They'll start, see, they're changing color now, they're turning orange. There we go. See how some of the rub's turning black or darker color? That's what you want to see. Not burnt now. Boy, does this smell good, folks. Let me do this, and when it's done, we're going to do the next thing. Now we're going to, they're not all the way done, but I turned it back down to medium. Now you get your Coakley's barbecue sauce. I thinned it out a little bit so that it can boil off the water and just be nice and sweet and thick and spicy. This stuff rocks, man. Literally rocks. And then we're going to add some of Surfing Sapo's homemade Louisiana hot sauce. Just a few dashes here and there. It's not very hot. It's more vinegary. There we go. Now we're going to bring this to a slight simmer. Isn't that pretty, folks? Look at that. Look how that Coakley works right into them shrimp. So you can tell this is a quality barbecue sauce. It's not got all that junk in it that no one knows what it is. All the ingredients are listed on the bottle. That's very important. Just because something tastes good, if they don't give you the ingredients, for all you know, you don't know what they put in there. I mean, could have put something in there that's addictive for all you know. I'm just saying, there are rules, laws of the land. go, folks. There you have it. I'm going to shut her down now and just let it get to know each other until it kind of cools off. And that's going to suck that Coakley's up in them shrimps. And we're going to feast. We're going to do a little trick with these two. Get you to zoom in before we go away. Isn't that beautiful? Okay. We got our dish here. Got the shrimp here. Get a scoop of shrimp. Put them on here. A bunch of juice in there. Put that on some rice. This is killer, man. Better than those New Orleans shrimps. And then, to make it even more interesting and delightful, I have picked up some Wowee Cajun dipping sauce. The spicy, mind you. So let's try this. Put a little bit of that to the side. Right there. We're going to end up putting these on a fork, like such, and then dipping them in there and eating them. We're going to dip a couple just in the juice. I already tasted it. It's unbelievably good. Unbelievably good. We're done now. Got our shrimp with the Coakley's and Tango Spice Company mixture. We got some Wowee, and we're going to taste the shrimp first without anything, just with the Coakley's and the Cajun spice from Tango Joe's. Man, I'm putting it in a bowl with a spoon. This is good, man. Oh, man, this is good. Now let's try the Wowee dipping sauce. Oh man, that's out of this world. Wowee, this really is a good name and a good dipping sauce. Some more dipping sauce. I can't say enough about Tango Joe's spice. The two that I've tried, and I can't say enough about Lloyd Coakley's barbecue sauce. And I can't say enough about Wowee's dipping sauce. Some really great products, and I'm blessed to be able to try these. And I'm thank God that H-E-B carries the Wowee's. I wish H-E-B carried the other two. Maybe someday. Mmm. Man, that's good, folks. It was my first time to make this. I made it out of cayenne peppers out of my garden. Came out pretty good. Vinegary. Anyhow, very good dish. Nice and spicy and hot. I like it. Coakley's barbecue sauce. It's not just for chicken. It's not just for beef. It's not just for pork. It's for shrimp too, folks. Among other things we haven't tried yet, okay? And that same thing goes for Tango Spice Company and Wowee's dipping sauce. They're good on everything. There's no limits. Okay? Alright, enough of that. Anyway, thanks for watching. Order some of these three products. You will be well pleased, I guarantee. I'm not kidding. You'll impress your neighbors and your guests. Might even make a friend or two. So, thanks for watching. Subscribe, comment, like. Please, I appreciate it. And we'll see you on the next video. Adios, God bless you, goodbye.